with Adrian García Márquez, and he is very excited because he's going to be doing play-by-play for Time Warner Cable Deportes. Tell me about how excited you are for this year.
I'm as excited. Okay, I'll put it this way. It's kind of like when a dad is waiting 9 months to see his baby. That's what I've been waiting, 9 months to get this started. We got the ball rolling in January, and I am ultra, super, pero super, super. It's the same word in Spanish and English, but muy emocionado, ready to go, very much.
Now, when I talked to you earlier, you said that you and Francisco have really been preparing for this, and you were doing mocks back last year. Talk about that.
It was a lot of fun. You know, going to Staples, it was too good to be true. I know at first we'd be sitting courtside, watching the Kardashians pass by, and all types of celebrities, Andy Garcia, what's up, and you know, whatever. But then after a couple of months, they said, listen, guys, we want your chemistry to start flowing, so we're going to put you up there. We're like, we were doing a radio game, pretty much. We're up in the booth. We started with Lakers, Celtics, couldn't ask for anything more to get going. And from that day on, all the way through the end of the season, we were doing those mock broadcasts, and it was just kind of going back and forth. And now it's to that point where we're going to hit the ground running, we're ready, and I think our audience is going to feel that energy that we feel, that passion for Lakers basketball.
Now, with this offseason being so exciting, what are you most looking forward to this season?
Well, I'm looking forward to giving the Latino audience in particular what they've been asking for so many years, which is that undivided attention for regional sports in LA, and especially Lakers, the crown jewel for a lot of Laker fans. For me, that is number one, just to be able to just put that out there. And number two, of course, I mean, you have caballos like Kobe, like Powell, joining up with them, Steve Nash, Dwight Howard. Can't forget about Meta. People always talk about the four. They forget Meta's going to have some open threes. He's going to kill some people. So it's going to be great to watch the Lakers and see how, I guess, after they go after that 17 championship and how they go about it. You have some major basketball IQ on the floor. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch.
Now, speaking of Kobe Bryant, it was his birthday on Thursday. Do you have a favorite Kobe Bryant memory?
Los 81 puntos contra los Toronto Raptors. I think
81 points, by the way.
Yes, 81 puntos. That right there, I remember at that time I was working for Telemundo. I was a sports anchor, and I was glued to my desk. I mean, I didn't want to go do the 11 o'clock news. I didn't want to prep for it. I didn't want to miss anything that Kobe was doing. So that I think that's one of the key moments in Kobe Bryant's career that I think as a fan, I think it's probably the most memorable. And a conversation I had with Kobe actually a couple seasons back, found out he's such a great guy, things he does in the community and what he does even with the video game industry to help veterans. I mean, things that you really don't know about and hear about, and you find out like this guy's not only a superstar, but he's a great person as well.
Now, when I started on air, I often had some funny moments or moments where the technology went out and things just went wrong. Do you have any moments like that when you started out?
Oh my goodness, I have too many of those. But there's one in particular that I think is gonna take the cake. I was doing the USC football for Spanish radio. We're in Arizona, Arizona State. They didn't have a box for us always. It happens, Spanish radio, Spanish TV, there's never a booth. So they put us on the roof. Okay, it's 108, 109 degrees outside. We're on the roof of the press box's roof. Okay?
That sounds dangerous.
It was. We were like down there, we barely see it. It looked strange. But
you guys
was,
like strapped in?
Nah, but I did need a couple of oxygen masks. And it was kind of like, I'm going to parachute down for a soda. No, it was a lot of fun. But it was probably the most memorable moment I've had as a broadcaster. It's kind of like we're sweating. Luckily, we're not on TV because we were sweating. It was a crazy afternoon, but it was USC football, so it was worth it.
Well, thank you so much, Adrian. Make sure you catch him on Time Warner Cable Deportes.